So the goal of these modules is to do a quantitative analysis of causality. So to do that, we're going to have to measure any variables that we want to understand. Okay? Now, a variable is just some characteristic of the unit of analysis. Okay? And what I mean by unit of analysis is things like countries, city blocks, people, villages, firms. So these are the units of analysis, the things that we're going to analyze, the things that are in our data sets. So we have data on different people, data on different countries, data on different villages. So the collection of all of these units is called the population. The population of firms, the population of villages. This is the set of all the people in the United States, for example, or all the villages in Nigeria, etc. There are two main variables that we have to measure. The first is the outcome variable. This describes the characteristic that we want to affect, the characteristic that we want to change. For example, how healthy you are in your old age. Okay. The second variable we want to measure is the policy variable, or the treatment variable. This describes the characteristic of a unit of analysis that we're going to use to change the outcome variable. Okay? So if our outcome variable is health, then our treatment variable might be whether you have health insurance or not. And these are both characteristics of a unit of analysis. For example, a person. A person has a value of how healthy they are and a value of whether they have the treatment or not, whether they have health insurance. Okay? So there are lots of examples from public policy besides healthcare. For example, our outcome variable is a measure of economic development. Our policy variable is a measure of how strong property rights are. Or our outcome variable could be the amount of crime on a city block. And the treatment variable would be how many police are stationed to that city block. So more concretely, when we actually do the analysis, we're going to have to pick exactly how we're going to measure these guys, okay? So the amount of crime is an abstract concept. We're going to have to pick exactly how we're going to measure crime. So for example, you could say the number of car thefts on a city block. That's something you can just count, get and look up in your data. Then to measure treatment, how many police are stationed there, you could, for example, see did a city block get extra police or not relative to the average level in a city? For property rights, suppose we want to measure the effect of property rights on economic development. Well, there the outcome variable is economic development. It's a pretty abstract concept. So in order to do a quantitative analysis, we're going to have to figure out how do we measure that. So one way is to just use GDP, gross domestic product. That's the number, you can look it up how it's defined. Then, the treatment variable, this is the thing that we want to affect economic development, that we have to measure too. So here it's property rights. So how do we measure property rights? Well, we could define a number that tells us the risk of expropriation by a foreign government, okay? So what this means is if you are a company and you invest in some country, how likely is it that that country's government is going to just take away what you own there, take away your oil rigs, your manufacturing plants, etc.? If it's not likely at all, then there are strong property rights. If it's very likely that they're going to take what you own, then there's weak property rights. Okay? And people will figure out how to measure these things quantitatively. Now, it's not always easy to measure what we want. And a huge part of research is often figuring out exactly how to do this. Exactly how do you measure difficult things? So for example, think about how do we measure hope, okay? Why would we want to do that? Well, suppose we were interested in knowing whether poor children who have hope have better outcomes than children without hope. So for example, do children with hope get more education? So how do you measure hope? Pretty big concept, right? But there's a paper, 2013. What they did is they asked children to draw a picture of yourself in the rain. And then they used characteristics of the drawings, like whether the child has a mouth or not, whether it's holding an umbrella or not, etc., to define a quantitative measure of hope. So I've got a few of those pictures here. So here's one picture. This kid, he's standing here, he's smiling, he's got a block face, he's got an umbrella here, okay, and he's got his hand up. Look how happy he is. This guy is so happy, right? Now here's another picture. This person is standing in the rainstorm, soaked, doesn't have an umbrella, is frowning, doesn't look very happy. Well, based on their quantitative measure of hope, this person is at the 93rd percentile of hope. That means they have a lot of hope. They're very high up there. The second picture, this person's near the bottom. They're at the 15th percentile of hope. They basically have nothing. Okay? So there are very, very creative and innovative ways that people have made to measure difficult concepts like hope. Now for these modules, we're going to assume that this step has already been done, that someone's already figured out how to measure what we want to look at. And the only question is, how do we determine from data on the policy variable, how much hope there is, and the outcome variable, how much education a poor child gets? How do we determine from data on that what the causal effects are, or whether having hope actually does increase the amount of education you may have?